It's Sunday the 15th of January 2017. I had a wonderful, wonderful last night, but I'll tell you about that a little later on in the show. First, a few news stories for your boys and girls. Do you know, this is the second time I've done the show today. I did it once and I thought, I'm not happy with that. I watched it and I thought, I had a feeling it didn't kind of flow. Do you know what I mean? We do like it to flow, don't we? Not stuttering left, right and forward. So hopefully this one will flow a little bit further. Now, do you have a pet fish? Huh? Swimming around in that bowl. What a boring lover. They're supposed to have only memories of 5 minutes. I think it's very cruel to have a fish in a bowl or a tank. And I don't care how big your tank is. They should be out in the ocean free. I'm free. Everybody's free. Yes. They should be out in the ocean and free. Well, this bloke here, an enthusiastic fish keeper. This is in this morning's Super Sawway Daily Mail. An enthusiastic fish keeper liked nothing better than watching his colourful pets dart around the tank in his living room. And he's got quite a large one. Tank, that is. He's got quite a large tank, yes. But little did he know, however relaxing they were to look at, his tropical fish were making him seriously unwell. Yes, have a look at your tank now, dear. Is that worrying you? In fact, the 70-year-old contracted an incredibly rare disease that baffled doctors and left him struggling to breathe. Last night, the retired bus driver, whose illness was so unusual that it was written up in a medical journal, told the Scottish Mail on Sunday how cleaning his aquarium nearly cost him his life. As part of his fish-keeping routine, he would place one end of a hose. Now, get this. I don't know anything about fish. One end of the hose in the tank. Then he would suck on the other end to start siphoning out the dirty water into a bucket. Oh, my God. Although he never swallowed the water, he inhaled bacteria, which then infected his lung. I mean, why would you do that? Is this how it's normally done, then? Have you got fish at home? I know my mate's got fish at home. I can't see him sucking on the tube like that. Oh, what if you get a mouth of that water? Oh. And so those people, I mean, it's bad enough, those people that siphon out petrol tanks, isn't it? They suck one end of this and then they put the tube into another thing. I mean, I couldn't do that. What if you get a mouthful of the stuff? What if a live fish comes up the tube and you swallow it and it starts eating your insides? That could happen. He became sicker and sicker, but at first had no idea his aquarium was to blame. Instead, he feared he had cancer. Well, of course, you would start losing weight, depending on a persistent cough. After months of tests, medics revealed the astonishing truth. I'm now going to do an astonished look for it. It revealed the astonishing truth. That was an astonishing look for you then, boys and girls. That bacteria inhaled as he siphoned water from the fish tank. He had caused a potentially fatal fish tank. What is that? Granulomo. A type of lesion in his lung. Oh my. Well, so be careful how you clean out your fish tanks. You don't suck on a tube. Surely there must be another way of doing it. Can't you just get like a jug or something and empty the water like that? And then when it gets a little bit less, and you can just tip it out or something like that? Oh, no, I don't like the idea of sucking on tube. We need a bit of better news than that this morning. Look at this. A Brazilian businessman. Now, would you like to go to Brazil? I think the capital city, what's that? Is it São Paulo? São Paulo or something like that, is it? Is that the capital of Brazil? A Brazilian businessman added his riches after he betted $35,000 worth of betting chips on a single roulette spin. So just imagine that. Just imagine that. 35,000. Now, I don't know. Actually, does it say anything down there? Let's have a look there. I don't know. No, it doesn't say. I don't know if he went in there with, how much was it again? $35,000. And then put that bet on one single roulette wheel. And I know what the roulette wheel, that's that wheel with lots of little numbers in it. And they chuck a ball in. And depending on where that ball lands is where you either win something or not. They have it on the telly all the time, don't they? With those, do you see it on the telly? And people ring in, I think, and they bet money on that, but not this much. Or did he win that $35,000 going on all the different machines and other things in this betting place? And then eventually, right, let's take a risk. Anyway, he put £35,000 on the roulette wheel and won $3.5 million. Well done. The entire place erupted into applause and cheering, except possibly, of course, for the owners of the betting place. Do you do any betting? Do you? Do you go in a betting shop or maybe bingo? Bingo is betting. I love bingo. Oh, yeah. 5 and 9, 59. 6 and 2, 62. Kelly's Eye, number one. Have you ever wondered what is Kelly's Eye? Let's have a look. See if we can find that. Kelly's Eye. Kelly's Eye. Kelly's Eye. The number one in the license trade. What is it? What is Kelly's Eye? Bingo. Oh, hang on. Okay, let's try and do it. List of British bingo names. Here we go. Kelly's Eye. The pun, Kelly's Eye, number one, is apparently military slang, possibly a reference to Ned Kelly after the valiant comic strip Kelly's Eye, where the eponymous Kelly possessed a magic amulet. A magic amulet, isn't that strange and mysterious? A magic amulet. Oh, yes. Actually, it's got all the other numbers in. One little duck, from the resemblance of the number two to a duck. Me and you, number two, is a romantic line. Oh, he's got them all down there now. Now, talking of Kelly's Eye, last night we had Kelly Wilde's birthday party at Central Station, where I was DJing last night. I do every other week there. And, of course, the karaoke there on Mondays and Fridays. And it was this lady's birthday last night who's been singing for years and years and years. She had a big hit with Gloria. And also she nearly got a song in at the Eurovision Song Contest some years back now. But unfortunately, they didn't quite pick her one, which was better. I think it was Better Be Good To Me. Oh, Better Be Good To Me. Oh, yeah. And anyway, so last night she was... her birthday night. It was indeed. And here she is singing a little bit of her hit Gloria. Lovely Kelly. Actually, I do a little bit of work for her. As well as being a singer, she runs an entertainment agency and I'm on her books. And in fact, the two or three jobs sometimes that I do at Central Station go through her. She kind of put me in there. So wonderful. So happy birthday to Kelly for yesterday. And there were lots of other people there, including Jason Prince was there. And we had Marcella Woods, who's quite a famous singer. Also, one of my icons of all time. I got to push the buttons for Angie Brown. Oh, yeah. I'm going to get you, baby. I'm going to get you. Yes, I am. Oh, it was fab. She's as mad as a hatter. That's probably why we got on so well. I met one of my singing icons. She is more famous known for the song I'm going to get you. Remember that one with Bizarre Inc.? I think it was about 1992-ish. Big, massive hit that was. So I also did a little bit of a video of Angie Brown singing I'm Gonna Get You, Baby. Here it is. Why don't you talk? You know you're gonna be mine. You know you're gonna be mine. Why don't you talk? You know you're gonna be mine. 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 Yeah, I'm gonna get you, baby. Little Angie Brown. Lovely to meet you, my darling. An absolute pleasure and an honour to be pushing the buttons for you to sing to our massive audience that were here last night. Lots of love to Angie Brown. And, of course, Kelly Wilde as well. Next week here on the show, Barry Manilow will be making an appearance as well. All right. Followed by Shirley Bassey as well. Some messages from yesterday's show, and then we'll do today's birthdays. Hello to Rachel, who informs us, because I sent my old Christmas star to the lovely Joanna. And Rachel says, the post to Joanna will take anything up to 3 weeks. Okay, so that's fair enough. She might not have got that yet. I only posted about a week ago. She wanted my Christmas star that was hanging. That's all I had in the studio this year. The whole of the Christmas decorations was a Christmas star there. That was it. That was it. The poinsettia, as you can see, is still okay. But it is dropping a lot of leaves. So I think I'm going to lose this one as well. And it's... You know, it's fairly damp in there. There's no water in the bowl, so I don't think I've overwatered it. I have to tell you, Ray Reynolds will be watching this show as well. I have to tell you, Ray, that 2 leaves this morning dropped off on the rubber plant downstairs. So I'm not sure that you should give me any more of your plants. I don't know why your plants do not survive in here for some reason, in this house. Don't know why. Everything I grow, it's fine. I don't understand why you're... And you've given me, I think, 3 or 4 plants now. None of them have lived. You better not come here. All right, thank you, Ray. Hello to John Child. Hello, John. Are you coming along tomorrow night, John, to the karaoke? I do hope so. John says, regarding on yesterday's show being asked to continue after your allotted time when you're doing a job, I can remember one New Year's Day. I was doing a karaoke DJ set at a pub in the afternoon between 4 p.m. and 8 p.m. Well, that's a nice time to do a job. I haven't had any of those. 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. And I was still there at 1 a.m. absolutely knackered by the end of that one. I should think you were. My word. I also have to say that I found when I was in entertainment work mode, I was totally in the moment and time and other problems were immaterial. The high, and this is absolutely true, and I know this is the same for Kelly as well. The high that you get on stage and performing are amazing. It's the crash after you finish that is the real downer. I wonder how many DJs, performers get nervous and suffer from stage fright before they perform. I know it was never a problem for me. Actually, John, I do. I do. I can be driving to work and oh no, I'm a little bit nervous tonight. And you must. And it, I don't know why it doesn't show, but I do get nervous before, in particular before the quiz night. Actually, I get very nervous before the quiz night. You know, that's getting harder and harder because everyone's Googling the bloody answers all the time. You know, and actually, you can find the answer that you want on Google. We had an example of this actually on two examples actually on Wednesday night. Now, what was the question was, oh, when was the first UK mobile phone call made? And the answer came, and so that was it. And actually, it was one of the bar staff. And so I announced the answer and announced the winning team because that was actually a tiebreaker question. And then he's come running over. He says, oh, you've got that wrong. It's here. Da-da-da-da. So he's reading. And he's a nice lad. He's not trying to trip me up or anything. And so he's reading. I said, oh, blimey. I said, well, I can't do anything about it now. I've announced the winner. I can't take it away from now. And then you know, it's done. Anyway, a little bit at a time. And then he came over to me. He said, did you say in the question it was the UK mobile phone? I said, that's right. Ah, he said, well, this is the American one. But do you see the confusion that created for a while? And it's really annoying when people are Googling answers all the time because you will find, I'm sure you will find your answer. And don't ever trust anything on Wikipedia. A lot of that cannot be trusted. You know, anyone can edit Wikipedia. So thank you for that, John. Yes, I do. I do get nervous. And I also quite often have a crash afterwards. So not a crash in the car. Well, sort of a crash in the car, but not the car crashing. I can come out of a busy night. And lovely people want to say thank you to you, which is great. You know, people come and give you a hug. And I love all that. And then you go out the door. you go around the corner where no one can see you, and you literally come down like that. You do. And I can sit in the car, and I'm like, oh, God, I'm tired now. And I would not have done that while I'm up there, or at least I hope I wouldn't have done. So you do come down with a bit of a crash quite often when you're out of sight. But that's the job. And I think you'll find, even if you speak to very big famous stars, perhaps, and people like that, when the show is over and you do, you come straight down again. So, yes, that does happen to me quite a lot, John. Always has done. It happened worse when I was doing a 70s and 80s night at the Black Cap in London. That was mainly in the 90s, that 70s. It was in the 90s. No, from 89 to about 1997. 1997, 1998, we did a 70s and 80s night at the Black Cap. And it was packed. Absolutely rammed in there, and I would come out of there, sit in the car, and I don't cry now. I would come out of there off the big stage, trying to get through everyone, saying goodbye and that. I get in the car, go around the corner, and I'd have to. God, blimey, how did I get away with that? You know, because I didn't really have much confidence in myself. I still don't, believe it or not. I still don't have any confidence in myself at all. But that one particularly, I used to go around and there would be tears in my eyes for some reason, and I couldn't understand what it was. Isn't that strange? So, yes, John, I know exactly what you mean. Hello to Simon, who says, Ari, on the subject of sushi, we were talking about sushi yesterday. Oh, how can anyone eat that? It's not even cooked. Bits of rolled up dead fish in a little plastic thing. Vile, dear. Give me chips any day. How can you sit there and eat sushi, dear? If you saw the show yesterday, you would have seen what we're saying about the bits of plastic they keep finding and all that in there now. Micro beads, which are so small, they're tiny little bits of plastic that these fish are eating, and then you're eating as well. Yes. Simon says, Ari, on the subject of sushi, I love eating raw fish. Very good for you. Oh, no, thank you. I'll stick to my chips and pies. My vegetarian corn pies, thank you very much. No dead animals will pass these lips. Thank you. Simon also says, on the subject of, I think it was Danny who's got a pain. Yeah, Danny's got a pain in his side. We think it's an appendix problem. And Simon says, a burst appendix, Danny, get that sorted. I ignored the pains and I was 15 hours from death as it was that bad. Seriously, get it fixed, Dan. When they released me from hospital, they told me to rest for a week and not lift anything heavy. So, yes. So I said, who will take me to the toilet then? Oh, dear. I had a burst appendix, Simon. That was, that's a number of years ago now. 2000, I think it was. I had a burst appendix. It had been rumbling, actually, for years. And they kept sending me home with... not constipation, with... was it constipation? Wait a minute. What is it they sent me home with? It might have been constipation. They sent me home and told me to eat some bran flakes. Three times I went to the hospital over a period of years with this problem. And then suddenly it became really bad and the pain just wouldn't go. And I managed to struggle down to the doctor who pushed and he sent me straight down to the hospital. And I went in there. And while I was in the hospital, the pain became so bad. And at that point it had burst and I had to clear me out and hose everything inside, all the poison away and that. And after that, I had a lot of problems. In fact, I've had a lot of problems with my stomach ever since. You know, so that is something that needs to be sorted, Danny. Good morning to Kiki D, who couldn't hear us yesterday. She says, put the microphone on. It is. Do you know, actually, you'd be surprised, Kiki D, the amount of people that email in and say, oh, I can't hear anything. And then you say, is the sound all right? And loads of people come back and say, yes, it is all right. So it's nine, almost always... if you can't hear me or there's something wrong with the sound, it's usually your end. Like 99 times out of 100, it's your end because everyone else it's okay with. All right, my love, Kiki D, you beautiful lady. Look what I got at church this morning. Oh, yes. We have our new church diaries. Bit late, Oh dear. This morning I had to get the car out because it was pouring down with rain. I usually cycle to church. I go to the Corpus Christi Church in Wokingham on the Sunday morning for 9 o'clock. So I get up our seven for that. And we got free diaries today. Look, free little diaries. Look at that. Isn't that lovely? Little diary. You can't have one unless you're a member. Are you a member? No. You remember, I just told you the other day, didn't I? I was a bit desperate for a toilet the other day. So I popped in. I actually was the Corpus Christi. I was cycling past and I got a pain in my side. So, oh my God, I need to go to the toilet. So I just popped in our local church. You know, you can do that if you remember. If you're not a member, you have to hold it or you have to go behind a bush. And that's it. If you're a member, you get a little diary. Not a member, you'll have to buy one. Thank you. Free diaries for all the Catholics. How wonderful. I can put my little notes in here so I never, ever miss a booking. Mind you, I've got about three calendars here. I've got a calendar on the wall there that lovely Wendy bought me. The Barry Manilow calendar for this year, 2017. And, of course, my bookings calendar, which is here. Which, I think I've got the next two Saturdays off, actually. Two Saturdays in a row off I've got. Yes, I have. And I'm meeting up with some of my friends on Tuesday night. It's my friend's birthday, Rodney. So we're looking forward to that. In the Duke of Cornwall, who might be interested in a karaoke night, actually, for Saturdays. I've got too many Saturdays off. I've got every other Saturday off. And I would like to work some more Saturdays, to be honest. So that might be a permanent fixture there if I can get in there and see how we go there. All right. Was there something else to... I'm sure I had something else to read you here this morning. Maybe it's on here, is it? Oh, yes, that was it. Yeah, so I got the... So I took the car out this morning. I had to say, I had another bad night's sleep last night. Now, it always seems to be on a Saturday. I've noticed this. If I have a bad night's sleep, more often than not, it's a Saturday. Now, whether or not it's the fact that I know I've got to be up at 7:30 in the morning... You know, to leave the house at 20 past eight to go to church. I don't know if that's what's doing it. I've got an alarm on the telly and on the radio, which both go off. There's nothing going wrong there. So I don't know why I keep having a bad night on Saturday. Now, it's now coming up to 11:45 in the afternoon where I'm about to finish recording this. And I'm really tired and I can see myself having lunch and going back to bed. I'm not quite sure why that is. Usually I get up around about 8:30, 9 o'clock in the morning. So it's not much different to that. And indeed, I was in bed by 2. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 5 hours is good. 5 or 6 hours is fair enough. But I find I'm just not getting off to sleep on the Saturday night after I come in. Or indeed, if I've had a night off. So I'm not quite sure why that is. Let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. It's birthday time. Let's see if we recognise anyone today. Ah, yes, Simon Bell today. Happy birthday, Simon. 68 years old today. Happy birthday, Simon. Happy birthday to Dek Reid, who does lots of internet radio, a bit heavy house music. We like that. Dek Reid is 39 today, up in Scotland. Martin Oconner today is 27 years old. Jacee Badeaux is 21. I hope I've pronounced your surname all right there, my darling. Jacee Badeaux and Brian Pople. Is it Pople? I think it's Pople. Happy birthday today to Brian Pople, who is... I think I did see a little age there. You don't mind me reading your age. Is 64. You're not the oldest one today, Brian, I'm afraid. Oh, no, you're not the oldest one today. But Brian Pople is 64 years old today. So let's do the song, gang. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Simon, Dek, Martin, JC and Brian. Happy birthday to you. All right. Enjoy your birthday, boys and girls, and thanks very much for joining us on this Sunday for today's show. If you want to send in an email, I've got an email address. It's chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Or, as always, you can just put a little message underneath this on my Facebook, OK? My Facebook is facebook.com/chrisreardonuk. Enjoy your Sunday. See you soon. Bye-bye.